Samuel, wilt thou live together with this woman after God's ordinance in the holy estate of matrimony? Wilt thou love her, comfort her, honor her, and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all other, keep thee only unto her, so long as ye both shall live?
I will.
Paige, wilt thou live together with this man after God's ordinance in the holy estate of matrimony? Wilt thou obey him and serve him, love, honor, and keep him, in sickness and in health, and forsaking all other, keep thee only unto him, so long as ye both shall live?
I will.
Samuel, you're called to love your wife as Christ loved the church. That means that you will need to sacrifice your time, your ambitions, your personal preferences. You may need to sacrifice all of those things and more for her good. You must not look out only for your own interests, but her interests are now your interests. And Paige, you're called to submit to Samuel, to trust him, to respect him, even in difficult and important situations. That's going to take sacrifice. That's Christ's love, personal, better than unconditional, and sacrificial. Your marriage is displayed by God, designed by God to display just that kind of love to your children someday, Lord willing, to your friends, your family, and the rest of the world. And the good news is that you have the Spirit of Christ to help you do just that. So let's pray and let's ask for God's help and guidance as you carry out your life together. Those whom God hath joined together, let no man put asunder. Having said all of that, it's my great pleasure to finally present to you Mr. and Mrs. Samuel Potter.